In this video, we will be configuring the PItoPI interface. This PI process book display shows the data on a source PI server that I would like to bring over to a destination PI server. So, assuming that you have already downloaded PItoPI and installed it on your computer, you open up the PI interface configuration utility and start from a blank PItoPI.bat file. We click open and we select the host PI server. This is our destination PI server. And the interface here is installed on our source PI server and we will be pushing the data to the destination. So the first thing to take note of is the point source here. We have chosen PItoPI and an interface ID of 1. We can also configure our scan frequencies and add scan classes. In the PItoPI tab, you enter the source host name. So this is our source PI server, and I'll type in the name of it. In the history recovery tab, we specify the history recovery parameters, such as the history recovery only for forced history recovery mode. Otherwise, it will be history recovery upon startup and reconnect. In the debug tab, we can look at the interface status tag on the receiving PI server and set the messages to be written to the logs. In the location tab, you can specify overrides for the location attributes for tags. So no matter what the tag attribute is, it is overwritten for the PItoPI interface. This is particularly used when running PItoPI within a collective. This would be used in a situation where a primary PI collective node receives data directly from a PI OPC interface. The points on the secondary PI collective node are defined exactly as they are on the primary PI collective node because they must have matching PI point databases. Therefore, the overrides must be used so that the points on the secondary are signed up for the PItoPI interface instead of the PI OPC interface. Please see the PItoPI user guide for more information on the PItoPI interface specific configurations. In addition, disconnected startup is recommended for faster startup times. To do this, you must disable PySDK and then go back to disconnected startup and we'll check that. And back at disconnected startup, we will enable that and choose a cache path where the shared file will be located. It's also recommended that the PyBuffer subsystem be used when sending data from the source PI server to the destination PI server and the interface is configured on the source PI server. Next, we'll create the service and we'll start the interface. Looking back at our PI process book display, the destination tag on the destination PI server is receiving data from the source PI server. We recovered historical data for this tag using PItoPI because the data of interest are after the destination point was created. If we wanted to recover history before the destination point was created, then we would have to use the backfilling with PI config procedure.